Speedometer readings for a vehicle at 4 second intervals are given in the table, where we have the time in seconds and the velocity in feet per seconds. We want to estimate the distance traveled by the vehicle during the 20 second period using the velocities at the beginning of the time intervals, which will be the lower sum because the velocities are increasing. And then we'll give another estimate using the velocities at the end of the time intervals. And again, because the velocities are increasing, this would be called the upper sum. Since distance equals rate times time, we can estimate the distance traveled by determining the area of rectangles over these subintervals using the velocities as the height of the rectangles. So to better understand this, let's first plot these points on the coordinate plane. Here they are on the right. For the next step, let's go ahead and divide this 20-second time interval into 4-second subintervals. And now for the first estimate, we want to use the velocities at the beginning of each time interval, which means we'd use the left side of each subinterval to determine the height of the rectangle that we'll use to approximate the distance. So looking at this first subinterval, we'll use the velocity of 24, or the left side here, as the height of the first rectangle. Notice how the area of this rectangle would be 24 times 4, or 24 feet per second times 4 seconds, giving us an approximation of 96 feet for this first 4-second subinterval. Continuing this pattern, we'll use the velocity of 30 for the height of the next rectangle. Next, we'll use the velocity of 36 for the height of the next rectangle, 40 for the next height, and 45 for the last height. So our approximation for the distance traveled would be the total area of these 5 rectangles. I do want to point out that the actual distance traveled would be the area under the curve that passes through the 6 points. Notice how the area under this curve would be greater than the area of these 5 rectangles, and that's the reason why this is called the lower sum. So the approximation for the distance traveled using the velocities at the beginning of each time interval would be 24 times 4 plus 30 times 4 plus 36 times 4 plus 40 times 4 and then finally plus 45 times 4. So this would give us 96 plus 120 plus 144 plus 160 plus 180, which is equal to 700. So using this approximation, the approximate distance traveled is 700 feet. Now we're asked to make a second approximation, now using the velocities at the end of the time intervals. We'll first form the subintervals, and now because we're using the velocities from the end of each subinterval, we're using the right side to form the height of the rectangles. So for this first subinterval, we're using the velocity of 30 as the height of the rectangle. Next, we're using a velocity of 36 as the height. Next, we'll use the velocity of 40 as the height. Next, a velocity of 45. And finally, a velocity of 48 as the height. So now we'll find the area of these 5 rectangles to make another approximation for the distance traveled. Now the reason this would be called the upper sum is because if we sketched a curve that passed through these 6 points, these points here, notice how the area under the curve, which would be the exact distance, would be less than the area of the 5 rectangles. So the approximation using the ending velocities would be approximately 30 times 4 plus 36 times 4 plus 40 times 4 plus 45 times 4 and then finally plus 48 times 4. So we'd have 120 plus 144 plus 160 plus 180 and plus 192, which gives a sum of 796. So using these velocities as the height of the rectangles, the approximate distance traveled is 796 feet. So in reality, the distance traveled would more than likely be somewhere between 796 feet and our previous estimate of 700 feet. I hope you found this helpful.